Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Trendonomics by Harshdeep. In today's video, I'm going to share my short-term update on Nifty, Elliott wave structure in short-term and medium-term. But before that, if you are new to this channel and you still haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon. That's how you're going to receive a notification next time I post a video on stock market, on Nifty, Elliott waves, some trading opportunities in stocks, on technical analysis. So go ahead and subscribe to this free YouTube channel and share with your friends. You can also follow me on Twitter. This is my Twitter handle @HarshDeepSit84. I share a lot of regular updates on stock market on Twitter. So you can follow me on Twitter. Okay, so let's see what's happening with Nifty. So as discussed, we are into a third wave of bull market, which started at 9800, and further we are subdividing as wave one and two. Wave two correction completed at 9500, and we are into a third wave, which is most powerful wave in terms of Elliott wave structure. So from 9500 we are into a third wave. Within that, probably we are into a fifth wave, which started at 10,265. And now currently, as discussed yesterday, probably we have completed wave one of five near 11,810. And then we were consolidating within this range between 10,800 to 10,680. So as discussed yesterday, we follow stop loss of hourly moving average. So we exited our longs yesterday below this hourly moving average, as Nifty was trading below and sustaining below the hourly moving average. We closed out on our long. And then we entered again today around 10 o'clock once market started sustaining above this hourly moving average, about 10,760. So probably now the wave two correction is over. Wave two, again, probably this is an expanded flat correction where A is a three-wave leg, then B as a three-wave leg, and a five-wave decline, a sharp decline in wave C, which we witnessed yesterday. And again, today we have again now started rallying. And we have, towards the end of the day, we have closed near 10,833. The adjusted close is near 10,830. That's the adjusted close, but the last traded price, the last closing price was 10,833. So 10,000, as discussed yesterday, 10,820 and 30 is an important resistance zone. Once we start sustaining above it, now we can expect a good rally towards 11,100 to 11,300. We'll look at the hourly charts. So as we can see, though on daily chart, market looks overbought, highly overbought, as the RSI is near 70. But the hourly chart, the hourly RSI, because of the 3 days of sideways action, hourly RSI went down to 45 levels yesterday. So that was kind of a cool off from overbought zone. Last time also, we witnessed such cooled off in RSI when we witnessed the correction from 10,550 to 10,210. So last time also, from the overbought zone of 77, RSI went down near 41, and now currently from the overbought zone again near 77, RSI went down to 45. So that was a cool off in terms of overbought zone to almost decent pullback towards 40, and RSI has taken support at 40, so that's a bullish sign, and now it's again closing above 60, and market has given a close above 10,820 to 830 on hourly chart, so that's a bullish signal. The daily adjusted close is 10,813. That's the adjusted close. So as long as we stay above 10,820 to 30, now we can move. So we are probably in a third wave. We are expecting a third wave rally of the fifth wave, which is extending. So as per the 1.382 extension of the rally from 10,265 to 10,810, we can test near 11,428, and in the fifth wave of fifth, 5 of 5, we can head towards 11,550 to 11,600. So the monthly chart of June was a strongly bullish candle. Then the first week chart of July was a strongly bullish candle, and in this week we witnessed a sideways action, and the market cooled off from overbought zone nearly towards 45 level on RSI on hourly chart. So it gives a room for market to move higher again. When the RSI goes down from overbought zone, it gives a room, it creates a room for further uptrend. So as long as we hold about 10,820 to 830, We are expecting a rally towards 11,400 to 11,600 in a third view. So that was about my short-term update on Nifty. You can, if you like this video, you can share with your friends. You can follow me on Twitter, subscribe to this YouTube channel, and share the channel to your friends. It's a free YouTube channel. So that's about my today's update. We'll definitely focus on price action tomorrow and in coming week, next week. Let's see. So keep learning and keep sharing. Thank you.